Hello guys, welcome to 13 Universal, Learning Beyond Barriers. And this is A-Level CIE Biology. I am Shedro. So we're going to be discussing A-Levels. The questions are from past questions, okay? So this is Plant Transport Series 2. You know, we have done Series 1 before, so we're going to Series 2. So come with me. Make sure you're solving this question with me, okay? Don't leave it alone for me. Let's do it together, okay? So the first question says, a region of stem of a plant is heated. Look at this, it's heated. To kill the cells in the living vascular tissue. Wow. Why are they heating this? What did the cells, the plant, did to them? What did it do to them? How would this treatment affect transport between roots, leaves, via xylem and phloem? Okay. Alright. So how will it affect it? So let's look at it. Xylem cells are like dead. Okay? They are like dead because they have no organelles. Xylem has no organelles. So okay? So because they are highly lignified, it won't affect them. So C and D. Okay? But before then, that what does that do? They give us key. Let's check. Okay, all right. This is the key. So this is transport continues, transport stops. Now transport will continue in xylem. Yes, so transport continues in xylem because they are dead. So they will not be affected. All right, by the heat, you get. But if you go to phloem, phloem contains. Of course, some living these cells are alive because they have organelles, okay? Few organelles, and then phloem contains phloem sieve tube is associated with the companion cell, which has protein. Is that okay? So if the companion cell dies, right? Because they say they kill the cells. If you kill the companion cells, there's no way sucrose can be loaded from source to sink. And apart from that, if you don't kill the cells, if you denature the transport proteins, it will affect phloem, because it has living cells, and of course transport proteins are involved, they could be affected. So what do you think is the answer? B. Let's go to the next question quickly. Some soil borne fungi cause wilting, you know, loss of water in plants that makes them weak. Okay, so wilting in crop plants by growing within the cell xylem vessel. So if they grow within the xylem vessel, it's going to be a problem. Which process will be directly affected by this fungi? All right, so let's look at it. Pause the video and let's see. So if wilting, okay, if fungi grows within xylem, okay, remember the xylem vessel. Xylem vessel, look at it. Of course, it has thick wall. Okay, xylem vessel, highly lignified. Don't forget this. Mind my diagram. So let's assume that this circle is water molecule. So this is a water molecule. All right, let's see. That's underwater molecule. That's water molecule. That's water molecule. Water molecule. Okay. Water molecules, okay. So this water molecule is connected to this. This is hydrogen bonds. So water molecules stick together. They, because of cohesion, they form hydrogen bond between them. All right, and that is why they're able to form water column. So this is water column, right? Water column. So I'm just trying to paint the picture for solve this question, right? Okay, so this is how water lives. Okay, xylem. Now don't forget that this is xylem in the leaf. This is top of xylem, the leaf. L is leaf. This is that xylem in the root. Okay, so don't forget that as this water molecule leaves, it leaves right the one here, the leaf, to replace water lost by transpiration. Okay, don't forget that water molecules also form hydrogen bond with the wall of xylem. Okay, with the wall of xylem, and then the wall of xylem, that's cellulose molecule there and hydrophilic molecule. So that is called What is it called? It is called adhesion. Adhesion, okay? So water molecules form a hydrogen bond with polar molecules like cellulose, hydrophilic part of lignin. I made the same mistake. All right. So, but you get what I'm trying to say, all right? So now, watch this. The hydrogen bond forms the water molecules set up water column, okay? But adhesion helps to maintain it, all right? So the movement of water leaving the xylem, top of xylem, set up a tension that pulls water column up, okay? Sometimes water molecule can move, they move along xylem wall, okay? But they cannot move, so they move along xylem wall. And for them to move, because xylem wall has hydrophilic part of lignin and cellulose is polar. Okay, let's see what will be affected here. So which person will be directly affected? Uptake of water by root, no it doesn't. Uptake of water by root is not done by the xylem, it's done by root hair cells, okay? Is not affected. Stomatal movement is not affected because that's not in xylem. Stomata is between gut cells, right? Development of root pressure. Development of root pressure is not affected because root pressure is just pumping solute into the xylem. And once solute is pumped into the xylem, what happens is that water potential in the xylem is lower than water moves in, okay? And that causes water to rise. Okay. Okay, that's root pressure. But it's a conduction in the apoplast. Well, water can move along the xylem, all right? So when these fungi, where will they grow? Within the xylem, okay? So when they grow within the xylem, they will disrupt cohesion between water molecules and also disrupt adhesion between water molecules, okay? And the wall of xylem, okay? So conduction in the apoplast is movement through cell wall, okay? So this will be affected, right? Okay, so you enjoying the music at the background. Please enjoy the music as we solve the question. All right, so the diagram shows some adjacent cells from the root of a plant, which is the simplest pathway, or water movement, which is simpler. Simplest simply movement, it must pass through plasmodic matter, okay? All right, see, this is A. Oh, what's the direction? Okay, A is moving like this. Okay, watch this, goes through this. It's only plasmodic matter is showing. We have C, okay, now this B is vacuolar, passing through the cell membrane, tonoplast of vacuole by osmosis. But water is moving by simplest is by diffusion. Water is passing through the simple. Plasmodesmata. Matter. See, plasmodesmata is this link between this cell and that cell. So this under plasmodesmata, matter, link between this cell and this cell. Is that okay? So A makes sense. Let's look at B. B is vacuolar. Okay. C is moving through simplest. Okay, but also passing through vacuole. Okay, through cell membrane coming out. All right, so it's combining vacuolar and simplest. All right, D is apoplast. Apoplast is from cell to cell through the cell wall due to, you know, what is due to. Okay, now apoplast is by mass flow. Water forms adhesion with cellulose. Cellulose has a lot of hydroxyl group. Is that okay? All right, so what do you think is the answer here? Simplest is purely from plasmodesmata matter, one cell to another through the plasmodesmata matter. So I think the answer should be A. Okay, pause the video and try this question as you enjoy the music. All right, so the question says, which organelles occur in large numbers in companion cell? In phloem, which organelle? So the question is, what is the role of companion cell? That's the role. What is the role? Companion cells help in the loading. The main role is loading of sucrose from the source, mesophyll, to the seed tube element. Now, sucrose is loaded by active transport. Okay? Secondary active transport. Active transport is involved in the loading of sucrose because you have to pump hydrogen ion out. Remember that? How that thing works? Okay. Do you remember that how that works? Let's assume that I'm just using this as a sketch. This is Okay, don't worry, let's get it sorted. Remember, we have you in mind. We want you to learn this thing. Let's assume this is sieve two element. Yes, see the sieve plate. Okay, now this is the companion cell, if you remember. Okay, companion cell, I'm just sketching it. That's well, okay, he has nucleus. Made a mistake again. He's trying to draw with pen. Okay, help me draw this. All right, good. I'm trying to draw this, just sketch, it's not a perfect diagram, just to create a concept. Now this is of course maybe source, there's a few cell that has a lot of chloroplasts. Okay, yeah, so guys, another mistake. Okay, don't worry, got you. We're doing this in to make sure you understand this. Remember, we think about you, right? We're thinking about you. Okay, to make sure you understand this, watch this. Okay, this is companion cell C. This is source, mesophyll cell, which is source cell that makes sucrose M. This is sieve 2 element S. Okay, of course, it's connected to another sieve 2 element, you know, that forms silent vessel, right? And then, you know, and that continues. Okay, so the job of companion cell is to load sucrose from here to here to here, right? That's the job. So, but remember, the first thing companion cell does is that it pumps hydrogen ion from the cell cytoplasm into its cell wall and sets up hydrogen ion concentration gradient. That hydrogen ion moves in back, okay, pumps it by active transport. Active transport requires carrier protein, hydrogen ion pump. It requires ATP to move hydrogen from low to high to set up concentration gradient. So because ATP is needed, which organelle here gives us ATP? Mitochondria. Did you get? So this hydrogen ion pumped into the cell wall, sets up hydrogen ion concentration gradient, and the hydrogen ion moves back together with this with sucrose. So sucrose is coming in by active transport, but by secondary active transport, because it's moving in not directly by ATP but by the kinetic energy of hydrogen ion. So two of them gets in here. So hydrogen ion, right, sucrose then moves from companion cell to this by diffusion. But because to set up hydrogen ion concentration, we need ATP, mitochondria is our answer, because mitochondria makes ATP. All right. Number five, a water potential gradient causes water to move through xylem. Which process is the main responsible for this water potential gradient? Okay, we did this in the first series. You should be able to answer this if you watch our first series. Okay, let me give you a sketch again. Sketchy guy. Let me sketch. I like sketching. All right. Now this is xylem vessel, the tube that supplies water from the root up to the leaf, no matter how tall the tree is. Now this part is the root part. Okay, once water makes its way here into the root, all right, passing all through those tissues, like, you know, from the soil it moves through the root hair cells, moves through, right, the cortex, epidermis, endodermis, and then down to this. So water is gonna move up. Okay, it's gonna move up, right? But it's gonna move up. But it's gonna move up. How does it move up? This is the leaf, silent part of the leaf, right? So water moves only down potential gradient. If water is gonna move from the root to the leaf, it's moving because we have higher water potential in the root and lower in the leaf. So what reduces water potential in the leaf? Because for water to move from the root to the leaf, the water potential gradient must be created. So what does that for us? What removes water from the leaf to the atmosphere? That is not capillarity, that is osmosis. No, translocation is movement of sucrose, that is transpiration. So So loss of water from the leaf to the atmosphere lowers water potential in the leaf, so that water potential gradient can be created between the leaf and the roots, so that our water can move to the leaf for photosynthesis to make bread and cake for us to eat. So the answer is Delta D. Alright, number six, during transpiration, what is the site of evaporation of water in the leaves? What do you think? Now the site is, what is the site? The site is mesophyll. You know, mesophyll, say, well, how does it happen? Do you remember this topic? And what am I drawing, guys? Just to help you understand, that's why I'm sketching this thing, to paint a picture for you. Watch this. Well, tell me what I'm drawing. Type it now. Tell me. If you get it, I'll buy you chocolate. Big one. What am I drawing? Come on. All right. Now watch this type of cell. This irregular shape cell. Okay. Irregular shape that creates air spaces in the leaf. I'm not going to draw a few. Okay. This is spongy mesophyll. So spongy mesophyll, water moves from spongy mesophyll from the cell wall into the air spaces by evaporation. Okay, this is how water potential is set up. So I have water vapor in the leaf. How is water vapor inside the leaf formed? By evaporation of water. Okay, now this is gonna move through the, of course, down potential gradient to the atmosphere. This is atmosphere A. Alright, this is inside the leaf. Okay, so don't forget it. So during transpiration, water evaporates first from the cell wall of mesophyll into the air spaces to form water vapor. The water vapor will diffuse to the stomata. This is stomata. This gut cell. This is stomata. So it moves to the atmosphere. So the answer is mesophyll cell walls. Okay, because it has large surface area. Alright. So the diagram represents the phloem pathway with adjacent cells from leaf to root in a plant. Okay, guys, look at what I'm talking about. See, this is interesting. Which process is occurring between 1 to 2? And what is the effect on the water potential? Good. This is, guys, look at this. I love this picture. Okay, this is how the sugar made for us is supplied to us, right? This is the source, mesophyll cell. It has a lot of chloroplast. Can you see? This guy makes sugar for us, okay, to eat and stay alive, have energy to run around, okay? Chloroplast. So this is source. This source is where sucrose is made, okay? Can you see that? Right? So the source, right, is always connected to companion cell. Companion cell moves sucrose from the source, right, to the C2 element. This is C2 element, okay? Now, of course, how does sucrose move from here to here? By active transport, okay? Active transport. That's how it moves, okay? I described it in the previous question, all right? That proton is pumped, all right? So back to where we are. Look at this, guys. So sucrose, remember that companion cell will first of all pump hydrogen ion from this cytoplasm to this, to the cell wall, and set up hydrogen ion concentration gradient. Okay, hydrogen ion will now move back together, right? Remember that pumping is active transport, okay? The sucrose moves in by active transport because it moves from low concentration to high, low in the source to high here. Then from the companion cell, it diffuses here. So measure this by active transport. So active transport from cell 1, right, to 2. Though first from here to here is active transport, okay? But from here to here is diffusion, okay? But the major process that moves sucrose out here is active transport, okay? From 1 to companion cell, is that okay? Now, we're going to go with this. So when sucrose gets here, what happens is that it lowers the water potential here. So the water potential becomes more negative. Low water potential is more negative. Okay? I'm not going to be less negative anymore. Okay. So what is the answer? Hey, good. The diagram represents a transverse section through a part of the root of the plant. Look at it. Beautiful, guys. This is beautiful. Isn't this lovely? Okay. Now look at this. The diagram presents a section through a part of the root of a plant. It says which value of water potential in the xylem and soil water helps to explain why water passes from the soil into the xylem across the cortex. Why is water moving from the soil to xylem? Why is it not moving from xylem to the soil? Why is it moving from soil to xylem? Okay, because of water potential gradient. Water moves just because of water potential gradient. It's always moved from high water potential gradient to low. So water is, all right, at high water, so it's going to move here, all right? And remember that high water potential is less negative. So it's moving from less negative to more negative, right? If you come to a water in the soil, the water potential is not zero, because 0 kilopascal is for water that has no solute, pure water, no solute. So there's no way it has solute. A is wrong. B says, okay, from less negative. Less negative means high water potential. More negative, 700 minus 700 is less. Okay, that's the case. Less than 1,800. Okay, so that's less negative. This is more negative. Less negative is high water potential. More negative is low. So water moves from high, less negative, to low, more negative. This should be the answer. Now, zero is no solute at all. Okay, that's not correct, because what xylem also transport mineral ions. Okay, and they cannot move from low water potential to high. More negative is low water potential, so the answer is likely B. Chat us and let us know what you're thinking. 9 says translocation in plant moves sucrose from source to sinks. Which of the following can be source and which not? Source is where sucrose is made, all right? Sink is where it is stored or utilized. Germinating seeds, sucrose can be made from the can be made from the endosperm. Okay, starch in endosperm is hydrolyzed from sucrose. Okay, or produce. Okay, green leaves, they can only be sink when they are maturing, but once they are matured, they are source. So this is wrong. Okay, this is wrong. So the green leaves are source. Yes, they make glucose converted to sucrose, so they can synthesize sucrose. Storage route is where sucrose is stored or utilized. Okay, converted to starch. So this B is correct. Phloem is no. Storage route cannot be source except in winter. So this is where it is made. This is where stored or utilized. So bravo is the answer. What occurs in the apoplast and symplast pathways? You can see that now. Of course, water enters cell wall. If water enters cell wall, that is apoplast. So C and D eliminated. Cell wall has to do apoplast, A and B. Let's go. Water enters cytoplasm through plasmal membrane. As long as water is in the cytoplasm, because it's moving from cytoplasm through plasmodesmata, that is symplast. So the apoplast is cell wall. So we have eliminated. This is B. Do you want us to go on? So the answer is B. You take it off, but if you want to go on, let's go. Water enters vacuole. Yes, that also can happen in symplast. Water moves from cell to cell through plasmodesmata. Yes, symplast. Water moves from cell to cell through intercellular space, apoplast. All right, so please watch this. This is the material. So we're using questions to teach you application and content. Right, so this is critical thinking. All right, so B is the answer. All right. In an animal cell, which process is dependent upon cell surface area? Which process is dependent upon cell volume? Okay, cell surface area, which one? Carbon dioxide produced, is it producing cell surface? No, glucose absorbed, no, can be absorbed. But hormones are dictated on the cell membrane. Okay, cell membrane has receptors for hormone. Yes, hormones dictated. Carbon dioxide produced, yes, that has to do because the larger the cell volume, that means that we're going to be dealing with, you know, more energy made, of course, more energy not made, released, okay? and of course more carbon dioxide produced. It's a gas, okay? So it's a gas that has to do with cell volume, okay? Hormones has to do with cell surface membrane, because hormones have target site. Target site is on the membrane. That is where their receptors are. Okay, the answer is C. So the diagram shows transverse section part of a plant. Okay, let's go. Yeah. C, come with me. Oh yeah, yes. So in the cross section, what do one, two, what does it mean? Now this is a leaf. Guys, what this is a leaf. This part here, what the highlighter is, this is upper epidermis. If you're coming from upper epidermis down to lower epidermis, the first part of these are vascular bundles. Okay, the first part of it, the one that emits first is xylem. So one is xylem. In the leaf, one is xylem is the outer part. Okay, so one is xylem, two is phloem. That's how it is in the leaf. Okay, so one is xylem, two is phloem, one is of a C and D. But let's go on. So A and B emitted, but in the root, stem and root is different. The first part of vascular bundle is phloem. Three is phloem. Phloem is three. So C is likely the answer. Okay, four should be our xylem. Now, of course, the outer one here is phloem. Number five is phloem. The one inside is xylem six. Okay, five is phloem, outer. Six is xylem. Please watch the arrangement. Okay, that's how it is. So the answer is C. All right, look at this. Yeah, like this real life scenario. Say, land flooded by the sea is not suitable for growing plants. Long after the salty flood water has drained away, the diagram represents a transverse section through a part of the root of a plant. Look at it. Okay, this is soil. This is flooded by the sea. The sea has a lot of salt. It's salty. Okay, now that makes the soil to have a lot of salt, so that lowers water potential. There's a which values of water potential in the xylem and soil water helps to explain why land flooded with salty water is unsuitable for growth of plant. Okay, whatever is unsuitable, that means doesn't allow water transport. Water is needed for a lot of reactions in the plant, you know, starting from photosynthesis. You know, water is a raw material in photosynthesis. Water is in there for hydrolysis reactions and a whole lot. It creates aqueous medium for reactions. So now that means that what condition prevents water transport from soil to water? The only way water cannot be transported from soil to xylem is if we have less water here. Water only moves due to water potential. Water only moves from high water potential to low. So if water, this soil is flooded by seawater, which has a lot of salt, that means that it's likely go to xylem. Xylem must have low water potential and high water potential, okay, than the soil. Okay, so watch this. So look at number one. Of course, zero means no salt at all. This is cancelled. There's no salt. So this is high, low water potential. This is more negative, low water potential. Okay, this is less negative, high water potential. If this is it, then water can be transported and the plant will grow. Okay, this is also not, this is eliminated because it has solute. Okay, but if you come here, this tells us that what xylem has more water potential, high water potential. Why? Less negative, more negative. So high water potential, low water potential. There's no way water can move from soil into xylem. Do you get? So the answer is D. Okay. So guys, thank you for listening. Catch up with you. See you. Bye. See you later. Bye.